Hey guys, your boy Kripers, and welcome back to my Fix 16 Liberal Chroma, where last time I picked the wins in the Champions League and in the league. In this episode, I have a league game in against West Brom, as you can see, and then I will have a Champions League game in that if I win, I believe I will be guaranteed qualification for the last 16, I think. Anyway, I might be wrong. But yeah. No, wait, no, it's not a Champions League game, it's a cup game. It's a Carling Cup game. It's a Capital One Cup game, sorry. Getting all confused because I was watching the FA Cup games earlier. And Man City, can I say, you absolute pricks. You absolute fucking assholes. You didn't even try. I mean, there was no scenario where that team would beat Chelsea. No scenario whatsoever. City went out to lose. I don't care what any City fans say, your team went out to lose. And you got what you deserve. Chelsea absolutely steamrolled them. And it's three defeats in a row since you got Pep signed up for the summer. Yeah, I think it's affecting the squad. I think so, anyway. Because now you're out of the FA Cup, you're fourth in the Premier League, fourth when you should be first. I mean, you cannot, and they have to realize this, they cannot put that same team out in midweek. If they are thinking, oh, we'll put out some weak teams, then we'll win the Capital One Cup. We put out our best players for the Capital One Cup. No. If you play that team against in the Champions League, guess what's going to happen? You're going to lose again. And yeah, if you do play all your best players against Liverpool and you beat us, you have the Carling Cup, but you're halfway out of the Champions League, and you'll be out of the FA Cup.
And this is a goal. No goal.
So, yeah. So what City need to do is they need to play all their best players against in the Champions League. They have to go for it. Because they have the easiest match. Because Arsenal are probably, they're playing Barcelona, they're going to lose. Let's look at the eyes. I don't care who you support, Arsenal are losing to Barcelona. They got lucky against Bayern Munich. Barcelona won't make the same mistakes Bayern Munich made.
That will be Liverpool's throw-in.
Because Barcelona right now are like a well-oiled machine. Can't seem to stop them. So Arsenal are pretty fucked. Chelsea are 2-1 down against PSG. Granted, that's not bad. You know, it's not good, but it's not bad. It's fixable. You know, they can still recover. They could still get through. And of course, Manchester United went out in the group stages because, of course they did. But yeah, City, they have the easiest game, but they cannot treat it like an easy game, or they are going to lose, like they lost today against Chelsea. So what they need to do is they need to at least play half their best players. Like, if you just put on maybe Kompany, Silva, Aguero, you can't play De Bruyne because he's injured, but play those guys, maybe Sterling, and then put the rest of the team as you know, fill the rest of the team with youngsters, then you might get a result against the in the Champions League. And then those players are Royce. You know? Then those players are ready for the final against Liverpool. Well, having got some game time under their belt, especially Kompany, because he's just back from an injury. Well, yes, you want to slowly nudge him back. You do want to give him some game time, because if he in their first game him back, you wouldn't want the playing as much. But so, you know, it'd be better if you give Kompany his first start back against in the Champions League. Then, and if the result is going well, then you can sub him off, and then he's fully ready for Liverpool in the Gabon Cup. I don't know why I'm giving City advice on how to beat Liverpool in the Gabon Cup. Our defense will handle that. That's because it's terrible. But City cannot expect good results if that's the team they're putting out. I mean, Iheanacho's good, but he's not that good. You know, he hasn't reached the potential to save you from an absolute thrashing alone. He hasn't reached that level yet. So, you're relying on him a bit too much when you're putting out the team that you put out today. Because a lot of those players probably played for the very first time in a Manchester City shirt today. Because there was a load of them. I guarantee half the City fans didn't even know you had. They're like, who are these guys? I don't remember hearing about their transfers. I mean, none of them are Raheem Sterling, none of them are Kevin De Bruyne, none of them are Otamendi. I mean, I know Nacho, I've seen him before. That's exactly what a City fan was thinking watching the lineup. Also, they were thinking, shit, we're fucked.
EA Sports coverage continues with the Capital One Cup fixture. West Bromwich Albion, they'll be facing Newcastle United away.
So Hiddink is still unbeaten as Chelsea interim coach. Now, if he keeps this up, he's definitely going to be with Shaw getting the permanent job.
Take over possession again.
You know that everyone's saying Simeone's going to get the job. I mean, if Hiddink gets the results, why not give him the job? He had it before, didn't he?
Barad, a goal.
This is where someone in the comments said would say yes or no. I think he did. Maybe that was an error from bases as well. I don't know. But yeah, if Hiddink keeps on getting anything, you know, I mean, he hasn't lost since he got the job. And if he keeps that up, then Chelsea will finish in a respectable position in the Premier League. And they'll win the FA Cup because, well, oh wait, they
near the goal, actually.
Actually, now I'm thinking about that. That stat was before they lost to PSG. I forgot about that. Having just talked about it, I then forgot about it. I'm brilliant. Well, he hasn't lost to an English team yet, so PSG don't count. They're not English. Plus, PSG haven't lost to anyone yet. At least not in France, they haven't. I mean, they could have the title won in France in about 3 games tops. Like, if they win their next 3 league games, PSG will have the title won. So yeah, that tells you how boring French League is. Really, Correa? How the hell did you miss that?
James Morrison. West Brom want to make a change.
Marco Reus. Damn. Good to you! Oh. Anyway, as I was saying, Man City need to stop thinking just because they have all the money they have doesn't mean you can put out whatever team you feel like and expect the same results. I mean, your main squad has lost two in a row to Leicester and Spurs. And then you go out and you lose again, making it three in a row, which is not exactly a good form to be going into two crucial matches like the Champions League first leg and the final of the Capital One Cup. Granted, Liverpool's defense will make it a lot easier for the City offense. And it's, I mean, we saw what Aguero did at, like, 20% or wherever he was back in November. Heard in the 4-1 thrashing. I mean, he scored a great goal. I mean, 100% Aguero will probably demolish us because our defense is terrible. Oh, but I don't have to tell you City fans that. You've seen it.
James McClain.
But yeah.
From the referee by the fourth official, that's the decision.
Ideally, Manchester City need to feel a really good team in the Champions League. They need to feel a good team in the Capital One Cup, because if they feel a lesser team, the chances of them winning they go down. And Chelsea proved that today. They absolutely smashed that team. And I mean, any team would absolutely destroy that Man City team. Any team. I'd even expect Aston Villa to beat that Manchester City team. And Villa are bottom of the table, and they lost to us 6-0. They didn't even score against us, but they would probably beat that Man City team, and that was out against Chelsea today. That team was a disgrace. Manchester City and Mauro Pellegrini should hang their head in shame. Anyway, a nice victory to start off the episode. Pretty good. Good. Just training quickly before the next game. Now, a lot of City fans are probably going to say, how can you criticize us for bringing out a second team when you're doing the same thing? First of all, I have a lot better players in this second team than City had in their second team. And one player who's actually the same. Nacho. Cool. Second of all, the City players, I guarantee you, they're not, they don't complain if they don't get a game. A lot of these players will freaking complain. And I don't want those emails. I hate getting those emails. I have a lot of players. I'll admit that. I am aware of this. And I will look to maybe solve the problem some way. Maybe a few players have to move on to different teams. I think it's highly likely that's going to be the case.
We're now down to 16 clubs in the...
Also, I'm feeling a lot of really good players. My lowest rated player is 69. Which is probably the average rating of the Chesterfield. And that's not any disrespect to Chesterfield. It's just, that's the way it is. And that's a corner.
In with a header and a goal.
And boom, see? Straight away, I'm doing better with my second team. Because my second team, I've actually played together before. Which is another reason. I'm allowed to criticize this Manchester City for bringing out their useless second team and getting steamrolled. Now, I get it. They are saving the big name players for the cup final and for the Champions League. But at least start the big name players and then take some of them off. I mean, Chelsea put out their full strength first team. Why? Because Chelsea can't win the league. And barring a miracle, they're not going to win the Champions League. So they see the... So hitting... Obviously sees the FA Cup and says, hang on, we could easily win that. I mean, Chelsea have a good record under me. I've only lost once. And, PSG aren't in the FA Cup, so Chelsea might have a good chance at winning it.
Here's the cross. Oh, it's off the ball!
And I bet if you said to Chelsea before they sacked Jose Mourinho, you might win the FA Cup, they probably would have said, yeah, if we're lucky and every other team gets played with all injuries. But yeah, no, all the players are playing good. But this is not about Chelsea.
Really, a throw. Not quite clear whose throw it is. And a sharp restart.
And I'm going to stop talking about Man City now, because I think I've made my point.
Well, that has cost them, but only a corner could have been worse.
So, I've got to focus on the game now. Go on, Nacho. Origi, make the run.
This could be a chance.
Yes, Origi. 2-0. Yeah, bottom corner, 2-0. Oh, beautiful stuff from the Belgian.
And that's gone like a torpedo into the bottom right-hand corner. What a shot.
Riggy, bottom corner, absolutely top class.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0. Wrong with that tackle. In fact, it was a terrific effort.
Turbe. Oh, turn on the jets to Turbe. Yes. Shoot. Oh, beautiful. 3-0. Oh. Turbe. Is that his first goal? That might be his first goal, I'm not sure.
He won't have scored too many better than that. He certainly won't have hit too many harder than he did there.
In this first half. Daniel Jones. Emre Can. Origi. And he claims the cross. It was, well, nothing's ever straightforward for goalkeepers, but he's
didn't get the header off. Challenged. Turn back, I guess. Still here.
Visibility of the proceedings out.
Chan loses the ball.
Unlike the players, who will be.
But we won't be doing that, Emre. Just saying, I mean, I'm looking for players to lose, and your name is probably pretty high on that list, unfortunately. Oh! It. Jordan Ive, what a goal! Oh, probably the absolute worst bicycle kick ever, because he was still standing. He didn't even jump, he was still standing. That's my first on-camera bicycle kick. I've scored a few when I wasn't recording. I've even scored a few scorpion kicks, to be fair. But damn, first on camera, FIFA 16 scorpion kick. Jordan Ive, take a bow, son. That was fantastical. Oh, this is a second in the Capital One Cup, apparently.
I have to say, it's so one-sided today.
Take the game's word for it. I don't know who scored in the previous games, to be honest. I don't remember. Don't remember what I did earlier today. I should really see a doctor about that. In any event, Reedy. Moreno. Oh, couldn't get the shot away. And there's half time. 4-0, not a bad lead. Gonna want to come out and get a few more goals. With no offense. Just a few, but I should be dominating you. I mean, I'm the Premier League and European champions. It would look bad if I don't absolutely smash you. So, sorry about that. But hey, you got a game at Anfield, so club revenue! Yay! So there's that. And that was brilliant. Okay. Seriously, like. Congratulations for accumulations. What's that? Riggy? Well, it's too early for. And actually wasn't there for school falls over. The Chesterfield player. Chesterfield player is down. He looks like he's hurt, but I know he's not because this game likes to fuck with players. Ooh! Not sure why I went for that, to be honest. Okay, we're gonna see it again. Yep, we're gonna see it again. He jumped a little bit, I guess. No. It wasn't like the Granny Shaggers won against Man City back in 2011 where he just freaking jumped like freaking. I don't know. Who jumps really high? Like a basketball player or some shit like that?
Jones.
I'm not following the NBA in a while, so I wouldn't really know anyone except maybe James.
One-on-one.
So, LeBron James.
And that's good.
If you're a bit confused. Like, maybe you don't watch basketball.
For the corner.
But like I said, I haven't followed in 2 years. This is my last one. NBA match. This is not a bad match. Focus on the game, Corey. Sorry about that. Got a little off topic. What was I talking about? Ooh! Good save by the keeper. Warpman, that's a few shots you've had, mate. It's cheeky. Already got a goal. Oh, and he's had a few shots narrowly denied by the keeper. It's Hooray! Boom! Top corner. That's his second of the game, if I'm not mistaken. Has he scored the third goal? Fourth was, Ibe's goal. Yeah. So, 5-0. Iturbe is now on a hat-trick.
Such a one-sided affair, but...
So if I get a penalty or a free kick, he'll be the first candidate to take it.
Only the margin that they lead by.
Yeah, it's not always.
And Nacho. He could get away here. Origi! Ooh, hit. Right. Hit the defender and has gone. For another corner. Hype, he was eyeing it. He was eyeing it. I saw that. Jordan, he is. Is he in a bicycle kick frenzy or something? I don't know what's going on. Oh, Ian Nacho with a powering header for 6-0. Oh, the domination, it's just too clear, to be honest. Wait, this is what happens when you put... League One team, I think? I mean, I've not been following the lower league, who got promoted and relegated in the lower league, so I don't know where they are, unfortunately. Sorry about that. Chesterfield, but I know they're in League One in real life, so that's where they don't have a bad team in terms of League One standards, so I don't think they'd get relegated unless they lost maybe a good player to a rival or something, or a rival got a new player or something. I don't know. I'm gonna say they're in League One, and if I'm wrong, then I'm sorry. Because I don't know. There's the full-time whistle, that's it. Game over. For two dominant wins. Well, I guess you could call that. Let's call that first game of dominant win. No, it wasn't a dominant win. Oh, I only have a... Oh no, I miscounted. So yeah, next game... So in the next episode, I do have my fourth Champions League group game. But first, I'll have a game against Watford in the Premier League. So that should be fun.
Okay, that's that. And my third keeper is thanking me for playing him when I didn't, which is odd. I'm gonna think skill man's in the next episode against him.
But yeah, until next episode, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe for more videos. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day.